brain is gone. His body lives, the autonomic functions continue. But there is no mind. We'll have to take him with us. Take him where? In search of his brain, Doctor. Where are you going to look for Spock's brain?
Captain's log, stardate 5431.4. For 15 hours and 20 minutes, we have been following the ion trail of the spaceship that has Spock's brain.
What would they want with Mr. Spock's brain? What use is it?
Time left to us to find Spock's brain. 8 hours and 29 minutes.
It might be a long wait. We may as well be comfortable.
What have you done with Spock's brain? What have you done with Spock's brain? What have you done?
Log, stardate 5431.6. Immediately after making contact with Spock's brain, Dr. McCoy, Engineer Scott, and myself were taken prisoner inside a highly complex civilization hundreds of meters below the surface of planet Sigma Draconis 7.
What have you done with Spock's brain?
We do not know Spock.
This is Spock. You saw him on the ship. You have his brain.
We just want to talk to somebody about Spock's brain, that's all.
Brain and brain, what is brain?
Bones. Scotty. Spock's brain controls.
Captain Kirk's hunch that Spock's brain is on this planet appears to be correct.
How does Spock's brain fit into this?
Go ahead, Doctor. Put the teacher on. Of course. A child could do it. A child could do it.
Dr. McCoy is proceeding to restore Spock's brain.
Never seen anything like it. He's operating at warp speed.
No one can restore a brain.
In a desperate hope that he can draw on Spock's brain for assistance, I instructed Dr. McCoy to give priority to connecting Spock's vocal cords.
That's better.
I shouldn't have done it.
What's that?
I should have never reconnected his mouth.
Well, we took the risk, Doctor.
As I was saying, a fascinating cultural development of a kind which hasn't been seen in ages. The last such occurrence took place on old Earth when the Romans were warring with the Greeks.